हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ऑल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट जनरेशन ऑफ हाई एसी वोल्टेजेस। दिस टॉपिक इज कवर्ड अंडर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ हाई वोल्टेज इंजीनियरिंग। व्हेन टेस्ट वोल्टेज रिक्वायरमेंट्स आर लेस देन अबाउट 300 किलोवोल्ट, ए सिंगल ट्रांसफॉर्मर कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर टेस्ट पर्पसेस। The impedance of the transformer should be generally less than 5%. The transformer must be capable of giving the short circuit current for 1 minute or more depending on the design. Third winding, known as meter winding, is provided to measure the output voltage. For higher voltage requirements, a single unit construction becomes difficult and costly due to insulation problems. Transportation and arranging of large transformers becomes difficult. These drawbacks are overcome by series connection or cascading of several identical units of transformers, wherein the high voltage windings of all the units effectively come in series. Series connection means output of the first transformer is connected with the input of the second transformer, and output of the second transformer is connected to the third transformer. So this way we can connect the transformers in series. The rating of the primary or the low voltage winding is usually 230 or 400 volt for small units up to 100 kVA. For larger outputs, the rating of the low voltage winding may be 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV or 11 kV. This is the schematic diagram of cascaded transformer connection. Here we can see three transformers are connected in series. V1 is the input voltage. Here we can see V1 is the input voltage and V2 is the output of the first transformer. Small a dash is the low voltage primary winding, and small bb dash stands for high voltage secondary winding. So output of the first transformer is connected with the input of the second transformer, and output of the second transformer is connected with the input of the third transformer. So this way we can connect these three transformers in series. One more thing, here we can see the some shaded area. This is nothing but isolation. So we have to keep isolation of these three transformers. Here we can say that isolation is at V2 voltage, and in this case it is at 2V2 voltage. So as the number of stages are increases, we have to increase the isolation level also. Here we get output up to 3V. It means output of this total system is 3V2. It means it is multiplied by 3. This is the high voltage laboratory at Dr. Subhash Technical Campus. Here we can see two transformers. This is one and this is two. Both transformers are identical. Its transformer rating is 50 kilovolt. Here you can see the input connection. Input given to this transformer is 230 volt AC, and output is taken from here. Output of the first transformer is connected to the input of the second transformer. So we can say these transformers are connected in series or cascaded, and output of the second transformer is then going for the measurement. So this full setup is two transformers are connected in cascaded. So the total output voltage from this setup will be 100 kilovolt. This is another arrangement of the transformer connection. Here T1, T2 and T3 are T1, T2 and T3 are cascaded transformer units, and IS1, IS2 and IS3 are isolation transformer units. And we can see capacitors also. So C1, C2 and C3 are the capacitance voltage dividers for high voltage measurement after first, second and third stages. And here V1, V2 and V3, these are the taken for the metering after first, second and third stages. One is for primary or low voltage winding, two stands for high voltage winding, and three stands for excitation winding. So here three isolation transformers are used for the isolation. So we can also connect transformers in cascade this way. Supply to the units can be obtained from a motor generator set or through an induction generator or induction regulator for variation of the output voltage. Isolating transformers IS1, IS2 and IS3 are 1:1 ratio transformers. 1:1 ratio means primary and secondary winding turns are same. It means there is no step up or step down. Same voltage will be transferred to the output. So this type of transformers are known as isolating transformers. They are insulated to their respective tank potentials and are meant for supplying the excitation for the second and the third stages at their tank potentials. Power supply to the isolating transformers is also fed from the same AC input. Now, advantages of cascade connection. Natural cooling is sufficient. There is no requirement of extra cooling fan or any other cooling requirement. Transformers are light and compact. We have already seen that 250 kV transformers are very small in size. Easy of transportation and assembly. Construction is similar to the isolating transformer and cascaded unit. Construction of both transformers are almost the same. Either star or delta connection are possible.
Drawbacks: more space requirement and expensive. Now, series resonant transformer. This is the schematic diagram of series resonant AC test system. In the input side, we can see regulator or auto transformer. What is the need of regulator? Because we have to require variable AC input. So by adjusting the arm of auto transformer, we can set the input voltage. This one is the excitation transformer. Here we can see reactor, and by using the reactor we can adjust the value of inductance, and in series with reactor we can see capacitance C. L and C both are in series, so this circuit is known as series resonant AC test system. Ratings of this circuit is regulator rating is 10 to 100 kVA, excitation transformer 10 to 100 kVA with an output voltage of about 10 kV. Reactor voltage each unit up to 300 kV. A voltage regulator of either the auto transformer type or the induction generator type is connected to the supply mains. The secondary winding of the exciter transformer is connected across the high voltage reactor L and the capacitive load C. We have seen this connection. The inductance of the reactor L is varied by varying its air gap, and operating range is set in the ratio 10 gm 1. Capacitance C comprises of the capacitance of the test object, capacitance of the measuring voltage divider, and capacitance of the high voltage bushings. So this is not a single capacitance, but it is a combination of all these type of capacitance. Q factor obtained in these circuits will be typically of the order of 50. Advantages of series resonant test circuit. It gives an output of pure sine wave. Power requirements are less, 5 to 10% of total kVA. You can see here power requirements is 5 to 10% of the total kVA required. No high power arcing and heavy current surges occur if the test object fails, as resonance is the failure of the test object. Cascading is also possible for very high voltages. Simple and compact test arrangement. No repeated flashovers occur in case of partial failures of the test object and insulation recovery. Disadvantages. Requirements of additional variable chocks capable of withstanding the full test voltage and the full current rating. Now, parallel resonant transformer. This is the schematic diagram of parallel resonant transformer. Here also we can see input side is a regulator or auto transformer. Then you can see the excitation transformer. Here is the reactor and here is capacitor. We can observe that reactor and capacitor both are connected in parallel. So we can say that this is a parallel resonant AC test system. In the parallel resonant mode, the high voltage reactor is connected as an auto transformer and the circuit is connected as a parallel resonant circuit. The advantage of the parallel resonant circuit is that more stable output voltage can be obtained along with a high rate of rise of test voltage, independent of the degree of tuning and Q factor. Single unit resonant test systems are built for about voltage is up to 500 kV, while cascaded units for output up to 3000 kV, 50 or 60 hertz are available. This is the practical resonant test system and it is outdoor type system. So with this test system we can generate very high voltages. Thank you.